father of news.
News team assemble!
Hello, everyone. We welcome you to our March edition of Millennial Monthly. I'm Marcus.
And I'm Chalisa. Our goal is to report information that can help you during the school year. So let's start off with something that can help you with your future plans.
Some of the top schools in the country, like Columbia University, are providing a way to get students one step closer to a master's degree. This online course saves the class of 2018 a lot of money. While attending a university for a master's degree costs over $60,000 on average, a micromaster's certification costs a little over $1,000. But don't be fooled by the price. The work required is just as hard as it would be at a university, which is one of the many hurdles students will face.
We as young adults know how difficult it is moving into adulthood, especially when it comes to finances. If you are at this point in life, suggestions have been made to attend an adulting school. Its co-founder, Rachel Weinstein, worked as a psychotherapist before coming up with an idea of an adulting school, seeing as how most of her clients were actually dealing with their transition into adulthood, like choosing a career or paying bills.
Think back to your elementary days for a minute. Do you remember the memories you created at recess? Well, your future kids may not get that chance. That's right, there is a movement to get rid of recess. On the other hand, there are those opposed to this movement because they believe that this could take away the only time kids have to be creative before they transition into high school life. The physical activity and time for creativity allows for a release from the certain mold that students are brought up to fit. Overall, the break from schools allows for a different type of learning experience that students cannot get from an ordinary day in the classroom. We asked people how they would feel if recess was taken away.
If I didn't have recess in school, then I think schools would be much better. I think that there wouldn't be as much bullying. I think there wouldn't be as many problems as there is today.
If I didn't have recess growing up, I think I would hate going to school.
Just because we're in one classroom all day learning for hours, so being able to play was essential to me.
Teens are revolutionizing the way to stay organized and complete a daily routine on time. Two teenagers, Sean Singh and Eric Vanderplas, designed a productivity app called Time. Ironically, this app helps people manage time for daily tasks and other things on your to-do list.
Well, speaking of to-do lists, some already find it hard doing work at school. So what do you have to choose between having a job or getting involved with a sport or doing an extracurricular activity at your school? You may decide to do all three of them. This is a common decision that high schoolers make. The question is, though, how do you manage all of this? So we went out and asked Christian and Brandon to tell us how they were able to handle school work and activities simultaneously.
It's pretty hard trying to manage my time between school and work because I come home from school, from my sports at like 6 to 6:30. I go to work and I don't get home until like 10, and then I still have homework and stuff to do, and it's pretty hard. To manage your time, you gotta be dedicated. You gotta not quit, you gotta keep going.
Managing extracurricular activities is pretty challenging if you're not used to it. But I started freshman year with being in band and in all these other activities. And, you know, it gets easier. It starts off hard. You know, you start off, oh, I got homework to do, but I got to go to band practice. But then I got to go to work after school. And, you know, you sit there and you think, think about everything you have to do, and it gets overwhelming sometimes. But that's why I encourage everybody I talk to, get involved in everything early. Start doing it early so you get used to it. So when it's junior year, you have a job also, you have a car, you have an actual life, not no offense to freshmen. But when you have an actual life, you have time and you're used to doing these type of things. You're used to being out there. You're used to being backed up. You're used to having homework and having practice and having no job and having to go to church and all of these types of different things. It gets like second nature, you know what I'm saying? So.
Puppies. Everyone loves them, and science has proven that they help the body release oxytocin, a hormone that relieves stress and anxiety. Some schools around the United States, including Fairleigh Dickinson University and Emory University, have both used pet therapy to relieve stressed students and help take a deep breath for a moment. With SATs coming up for juniors and some seniors, this could be the perfect time to stop and take a break.
I should probably use that. Seniors, if you haven't applied for colleges, do not stress. You can always apply for next semester, although you might be behind. So, if you're freaking out, it's okay. Remember, you can still apply. So, you're probably thinking, how and what? Two words, rolling admissions. This basically means that colleges accept applications on a rolling basis. They evaluate your application as soon as they get it. Although this type of admission is available, you should always plan ahead.
Did you know that your chapstick can be used as a candle, sunscreen, or even a flashlight? Well, little did you know, one stick of chapstick can come in handy in many occasions. Chapsticks have a variety of chemicals in it that make it a great lubricant for sunscreen and even cure minor cuts and scrapes. Who would have thought that a small piece of chapstick could come in real handy?
A new study has just come out saying that scientists are able to use stem cells to grow animal-free pork in labs, meaning scientists have figured out a way to produce pork without actually killing the animal. Scientists are still working out how this will all come together. But research has shown that this could reduce a lot of unnecessary animal deaths and animal cruelty.
What are your thoughts on stem cells being used to grow animal meat in labs?
I think in terms of animal abuse, it's nice because we're not killing so many pigs and other animals for meat, but in terms of using stem cells, I feel like there's way better uses for stem cells than to make food because we already have, you know, an abundance of that resource.
With warmer months coming soon, most people are looking to get that perfect summer body. To achieve this, exercise and a good diet are necessary. Exercising is the easy part, but what about food? In grocery stores, healthier choices are on average 47% more costly than junk foods. Here's the problem. How are you supposed to eat healthy and not break the bank? Here are some tips to keep in mind to stay in shape and keep a healthy diet. 1. Buy fruits and produce in season. Whenever you buy these items out of season, you end up paying 17% more than what you would if it were in season, and most of the time, the produce is smaller. Step 2. Try to aim for non-perishable items in bulk or frozen foods. Step 3. Make sure to use coupons and don't be afraid to buy generic versions. These are cheaper than national brands and will have the same nutritional value. Use these tips and staying in shape will be a breeze.
That's the information a lot of people can use. Well, nobody likes to spend a lot of money to vacation during spring break. So this is how to have fun on spring break when you don't have a lot of money. You can take the train downtown, and if you have your student ID, you can get discounted tickets. Downtown has a plethora of fun things to do, but most of them cost money. What they don't tell you is that museums have free days for Illinois residents. Just bring an ID that proves that you are an Illinois resident. You can also go to free improv shows, or you can bring your inner child and go to the parks. All that matters is that you have your friends with you.
That's a great option for some people. Smart devices have changed the way society has functioned as a whole. A common feature on smart devices is voice recognition. This can be a helpful tool for a multitasker or a person who's constantly on the go. But what does your device do with the commands you tell it? Voice recognition works like cookies, which is a small software that tracks what you search on the internet and tweaks advertisements or websites based on what you've searched. If these devices are truly taking information from us, how can you prevent it? The most common way is to turn off this function and making sure to always clear your search history or commands history. Until we know for sure what companies are doing with our information, it's better to be safe than sorry.
We all know air pollution is a serious issue for planet Earth, and it can affect humans in many ways. Turns out that air pollution doesn't just affect the health of your lungs, it also is linked to Alzheimer's disease. In a study that was published in the journal Translational Psychiatry, the chemicals that come from a polluted atmosphere can travel to the brain and accelerate cognitive aging. Plus, the cells in the brain's hippocampus would die off. The brain's hippocampus is the key to the brain's memory formation.
In the medical world, there has been quite a phenomenon that has made an incredible discovery. Scientists have found another way to give people heart and other organ transplants. Some people's organs fail, and the long search for a donor takes place. Now, there's a quick way to replace these organs without getting a new organ altogether. Scientists can now grow human cells inside pig embryos. They use a technique in labs which they take human organs or other DNA and put it in the pig embryo to successfully repair the human organ. A variety of stem cells are used, which can encourage the growth and reproduction of the existing human cells found in the organ. Unfortunately, only large animals, such as pigs, would be needed to host human-sized organs. But this process can help ease the shortage of human donors for many.
Facebook has taken aim at YouTube by announcing that it will add video services to Apple TV, Amazon's Fire TV, and Samsung's smart TVs. This means that any user-generated video on Facebook can appear right on your TV, which includes Facebook Live. Facebook is naming this app Standalone. We spoke with some students about this announcement and whether or not they will use Facebook or YouTube more.
I like Facebook better because you can watch like the same videos that are on YouTube, but not only that, you can connect with family and friends.
I feel like YouTube is better because YouTube is like the king of all videos. You can find any video you want is there. And not only is it, but it's any video, and then you can like circle up a topic and then boom, 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 all videos, you know? So that's why I feel like YouTube is just, it's just better.
I have to say YouTube because one, YouTube is a much bigger community than Facebook. It's like Facebook is just full of a whole bunch of amateurs. You look at YouTube, you look at big communities like ADD, BuzzFeed, like big groups like that. Then you got like the small YouTubers that do gaming and stuff. Like if you go to Facebook, like you're not really gonna be making no money if you're getting views off Facebook unless somebody takes a video on Facebook and upload it to YouTube. Then they get the views from that money. That would have to be.
Now let's send things over to our entertainment correspondent, Brandon, to see what's coming up this month.
Upcoming in questionably pasteurized music, indie band Milky Chance's new album, Blossom, is set to come out March 17th. The band's familiar fingerpick guitar style that is well known from their 2013 hit, Stolen Dance, returns, this time with a more alternative grit to it.
Alright then, it's morphin' time!
None of us really know each other, but we were all in the same place when Billy found those coins.
Mighty Morphin, loved as a kid, is back, and just like you, they hit puberty. The Power Rangers are back in a brand new blockbuster Hollywood film. The story follows a group of five delinquents that stumble upon a spaceship and become defenders of the Earth. Just as in the original TV series, the Power Rangers are back in red, blue, yellow, purple, and black, all morphed up with their Megazords. Dean Israelite will either have fans yelling, "Go, go, Power Rangers," or "Go, go, back to film school."
Thanks, Brandon. We'll be sure to check that out.
What's worse than getting cheated on with a stranger? Having your partner skip ahead on your Netflix series that you've been watching so desperately together. That's right. Over 50% of Netflix users admit they have skipped ahead on a show that they and their partner have been watching together. According to the study, men are more likely to cheat than women by skipping ahead. It's more likely to happen if the last episode that you watched together ended on a cliffhanger. People have even admitted to going to the extent of going inside of another room to abort their partner. So the next time an exciting conclusion happens that your brain truly can't handle, don't skip ahead and wait for your partner.
And that'll do it for us this month in March. So be sure to come back again next month.
And check out our YouTube channel at bdtv228.net. And also check out our Facebook page by searching Bremen District Television. For Marcus and the whole BDTV crew, I'm Chalisa, and we'll see you next month.
And cut. Great job, crew. Now strike the set.
Striking down. Turn off all the mics and the lights in the studio. Striking down. Turn off all the cameras to make sure they don't fall down. Striking down. One last cut for this month until the next show comes around.
Striking down. Turn off the prompter 'cause you can't scroll. I know who I want to switch the shot.
I know who I want to mix the audio.
That's our show. Striking down. Giving thanks to all the people who helped out with the show. Striking down, cut the recording off and send it out into the world.